I'm Melissa.
I'm Jason.
Welcome to Wine and Horror.
Alright guys, so I'm not going to go over the wine again. We went over it in two previous videos, so it's the Once Upon a Vine California Red Blend, $12 a bottle. But we're still finishing off that one, so I'm not going to go further into that. See the previous two videos that we posted if you want to get the tasting notes on that one.
Mm-hmm. This is our entry into Brian Rainey's Southwest Missouri Geeks 100 subscriber giveaway. So, he had five questions.
First of all, before we get into it, congratulations on the 100 subscribers. Channel's good.
I just got involved in his channel, enjoying it. Yep. It's a lot of fun.
Just started checking it out recently, but good channel, and here's the many more, and congratulations.
Yes. So he had some questions, and the questions were favorite pieces that are in our collection. And I've got some right now that are actually packed away that I haven't put up yet, that I'm not going to show in this video, but I can, it's a lot of my vampire stuff that I recently got for my birthday, and Jeff Soar's 1,000 subscriber giveaway prize box that I won. But in addition to that, it would be our Alien, full-size Alien. Or I think it's like 20, it's a 22 inch Alien that we received.
Yeah.
That's from NECA. So I really like that. I got it for Mother's Day. I don't have kids, but I do have a cat son named Elwood, and I got it from him and my husband for Mother's Day. So I'm really happy about the Alien thing. What would be your favorite items?
Yeah, so we have a Predator as well. It's like 18, 20 inches, something like that, the Predator. Those two really, to me, are the pieces that I really enjoy in our collection. Probably the most,
right?
I would say.
And so the next thing is, what is the items that we wish we had in our collection? What are the holy grail items? For me, I've got a few. So one of them would be from Sideshow Collectibles, and it's the Master from the Strain statue.
Yeah.
I want that so bad. They don't have it anymore, and I've never found one for sale. So I just love that. Another one is a full-size head bust of Nosferatu and Christopher Lee as Dracula. Honestly, wanting them so bad makes me want to break out some clay and start sculpting again. I used to do that back in college, so I'm sure I could find a community college that has a kiln around here that I could get them fired or whatever. But I'd love to start. I'd just love to have it so much that I'm willing to sculpt it myself if I have to. So, that being said, what would you say is your number one?
Yeah, so again, Sideshow Toys, if you guys haven't checked them out, check them out. It's just sideshowtoy.com, I think. But go to their website. They have a full life-size Predator bust from Predator 2, unmasked. And it's really, really detailed and nice. It's $1,200. That's kind of my holy grail.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is pretty awesome. Honestly, I don't think we have any statues from Sideshow Toys. We do have some figures and stuff, but no statues. And, they're really, really expensive, and we just haven't broken down and spent any money on that. But they're worth
stuff.
It.
Yeah.
They're definitely nice pieces. So if you haven't checked them out, make sure that you do.
Yep.
And then the next thing would be a funny face to get a baby to stop crying. And my funny face would be... I don't know if you guys ever watched In Living Color. It used to be a comedy show like back in the 80s and 90s. And It was, there was Wanda that was played by Jamie Foxx, and I used to like that character. I used to think it was hilarious. So especially if you guys have ever seen the one with Jim Carrey playing Bram Stoker's Dracula and Wanda, that particular skit is just hysterical.
Oh, then, hey, I'm feeling goofy.
Anyway, I'm gonna do my face of her, and that would be this. So.
And that's pretty
there
good.
There you go.
That's pretty good. So for me, I was kind of wondering what face really for, this is for a crying baby, right?
Yeah.
To stop a baby from crying.
Yeah.
But I settled on this one. This is my favorite face to stop a baby from crying. So that's my face.
Yeah, I don't know if that baby's gonna stop crying, but you can try that anyway.
As long as it's not my baby, I don't care. Yeah. I just think it's funny. Sorry.
Yeah, it is funny for sure. Okay, now we've got, he wants to know what our theme song would be. Every time we walk into a room, what would our theme song be? So anybody who knows me knows I'm not going to settle for just one song. I just, there's so many that I love, but I do have like a top three. So one of them would be Bloodletting by Concrete Blonde. That's actually a song that I sing, and it has to do with vampires. So naturally I love that song. So here's a little snippet of what it sounds like.
A sample for you.
Okay, so another one would be, for me, would be Burn in Hell by Twisted Sister. I love that song. I've been loving that band since I was like 13, 14 years old. And this song, I wouldn't say is one of their most popular songs, but it is if you're a fan. If you're a fan of Twisted Sister, you've definitely heard this song. There's just five words to say. So next would be Psycho Killer by the Talking Heads. Psycho Killer.
I had trouble narrowing mine down too, so I'm going to list a few of them. It really just depends on which, you know, what mood I'm in. If I'm in a mood for some rock, or if I'm in a mood for some rap. I would say this is one of my all-time favorites, and I love, especially on the horror channel here, talking about this. But this is Nightcrawler from Judas Priest. Some of you may know it, some of you may not, but I'll put a little snippet of it here too. The next one actually is Symphony of Destruction from Megadeth.
I wish I could headbang, but I might get sick or something. Can't handle that kind of movement on my head. Got the hair for it, but... Watch him become a god. Like a merry man, swing to the
When I'm feeling kind of groovy and wanting to
we bring out our Detroit side.
That's right, wanting to party a little bit with some hip hop, then I go to DMX.
To you cowards, then it's gonna be quick. Oh, you made up in the jail before. Suck my dick and don't let my fuck catch you.
That's all of our theme songs.
Could have went on. I
could have went on for days.
Could have brought on tons of these, but we had trouble narrowing this down, actually.
Right. So, okay. So, then the next thing was 100 sub shoutouts. Anybody who has less than 100 subs, who are we going to shout out and tell to go
subscribe to their channel and go check them out, right?
So, one of my first ones, or our first ones, would be Lamonia Demonia. She does a lot of hauls, a lot of Halloween hauls. She's really loyal to our channel. She's always coming and watching our videos, and I just love her comments, and I love that she comes by and visits, and I think people need to check out her channel. Yep. I mean, she does a lot of really cool hauls, so you guys should check that out. Another one would be Horror Fiend Reviews, and that guy, he does a lot of top five lists, more or less, and different reviews of movies, and I really enjoy watching his channel. He's got a lot of good information over there, and just love his channel. And then there's another one called Horror Reviews, and it's basically a couple of kids. They're just getting started out with their channel, and they're not, you know, super experienced at it yet, but it's quite entertaining to watch them. So I'm gonna put all the links in the description below. You guys should go check them all out and just, you know, subscribe and give them some love and, you know, see what they're about. So,
yeah, that's it.
Do you want to say anything else?
No, check them out. Give them a sub.
Yep. So, this is our entry, Brian Rainey.
Again, congrats. And, hey.
Yeah, got a great channel over there. I mean, we just got involved in it, but I'm really enjoying the content. So, cheers.
Cheers.